If you have your Bibles, you might like to turn to Genesis, the very first chapter. And I'll be reading this from the New Living Translation. And we're going to take a look at verses 26 and 27. And then God said, "Let us make human beings in our image to be like us. And they will reign over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and in the sky and the livestock and all the wild animals on the earth and the small animals that scurry along on the ground." And those brief words of Scripture, we read the biblical account of how God said human beings came into existence. Now, we're living in a world today where education has been teaching our youth that they were a lucky accident. But in this series, I would just like to take a look at the alternative view as found in God's Word. We discover that there are 11 systems in the human being: respiratory system, circulatory system, digestive system, excretory system, skeletal system, muscular system, and these are controlled by the nervous and hormonal system, and they are protected by the immune system, guided by the integumentary system, and they are copied by the reproductive system. These different systems compose 100 trillion cells. How many? 100 trillion cells. How many is that? Well, if you were to count to a trillion, you counted one a second, that'd take about 22,500 years. That's 1 trillion. And your body is composed of 100 trillion cells, and they, functioning together, create your life and the life of every other human being on planet Earth. And we might say as well as the animals likewise are constructed somewhat in a similar manner, but differently. And so we discover that the human body is composed of 100 trillion different cells. We got nerve cells, we got fat cells, sometimes we think we got too many of those, and then there's muscle cells, and then there's skin cells, red blood cells, white blood cells, sperm and egg cells, a connective tissue cell, and bone cells. Now, all of these different cells of the body have a nucleus. And in the nucleus of those cells, we find there are 23 chromosomes that came from your father, and there are 23 chromosomes that came from your mother, and together, wonder of wonder, they become 46. Now, isn't that a handy accident, that it just so works out that every cell in your body just happens to have 23 from dad and 23 from mom, with the exception of blood cells that don't have a nucleus, and sperm and egg cells that have just exactly half that number. Isn't that marvelous that it just happens to work out that way? Isn't that a lucky accident?
Cell. A cell is the fundamental or most basic unit of life, whether they be unicellular, one cell, or multicellular, many cells, all living organisms are composed of and depend on cells to function.
Our cells of our body are rather amazing, and they have looked at those, and they've discovered that every cell in your body also has 11 different systems that function very differently, but in harmony as one cell. And that one cell may be a nerve cell, it may be a fat cell, and it may be bone cells, blood cells, all these different cells in your body are all constructed very similar to what we're looking at here. In this study, we're gonna take Sir Frederick, and by the way, this is Sir Frederick. We're going to get well acquainted with Sir Frederick before the week is out. But Sir Frederick, tomorrow night, we're going to take a look inside of his hard hat. And you know, these hard hats are really hard. And man got the idea from the skull. This is a very firm protection of this thing called the brain. It's so incredibly put together. And tomorrow night we're going to take a look at that, the wonder of the brain and how it works. And anyway, we'll continue there, and we'll be taking him all apart. And so when you think about the nervous system and how it works, just to whet our appetites, these nerves are in constant communication with the entire body, and the brain is constantly receiving and sending signals to every single part of your body, and they move along at about 300 miles an hour, which is rather fast. Or was it the lungs? Are you getting the picture? No part of the circuitry could function or work by itself. It's got to all be there at the same time, and more than that, the circuitry system has life in it. Those arteries and veins live. They are fed. All 100 trillion cells of your body are fed by the circuitry system, and the life is in the blood, and it has to all work there. What about the skeletal system? 206 bones and ligaments. And by the way, we're going to meet Mr. Bones here. We might even move him out to the front that night. And this guy is quite a guy. You might want to come and shake his hand afterwards. But he's quite a fella, and we'll get acquainted with the bones. And you may think your bones are, you know, sort of the dead part of the body, but I'm here to tell you, what part do the bones play anyway? How essential are they to life? But here's the point. That bone tissue is produced from the DNA code. It is reading part of that code to make bone cells. And it only reads the part that makes bone cells. And what's even more amazing, those bone cells, as we're going to discover on Tuesday night, just happen to make blood cells. And which part evolved first? It's all got to be there, none of it works. And remember, 100 trillion cells make up your body, and your body is not unlike the universe, because, you know, we can go up there at night and look at the stars at night in the heavens, and with the naked eye, if you stay up all night, you can see about 5,000 stars. How many? How many cells in your body? 100 trillion. A trillion is a huge number, and not unlike our universe. And together, with unity, they function, making your life. The muscular system. And the muscular system, that's pretty amazing. And I forgot to take this guy apart a little bit, so let's just do that right now. The circulatory system, on that night when we talk about that, we're going to connect together the respiratory system, that's the lungs. And how long can you live without the respiratory system? Minutes. And then there's the circulatory system with its heart. And how important is that? It didn't happen 41,000 years ago. The Bible says 6,000 years ago it came into existence. And so the Bible says, do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, and you have from God, and you are not your own? I heard a guy say one time, I'm a self-made man, and I thought, I wonder what he'd look like.
There are two primary types of cells. Eukaryotic cells, which contain a nucleus and other organelles enclosed within a membrane, and supporting structures such as mitochondria, chromosomes, Golgi apparatus, cilia, and so on. Animals, plants, fungi, and humans are made up of eukaryotic cells. Prokaryote cells. Prokaryote cells lack a membrane-bound nucleus, mitochondria, or any other membrane-bound organelle. Bacteria are an example of a prokaryote cell. These cells have a cell envelope and have a more rigid structure than a eukaryote, except some different strains of bacteria and some types of microbes. Prokaryote cells often have flagella and or pili to help with movement and communication.
Let the earth be separated from the water. And then God said, let it bring forth green plants. And our one little world is not unlike our one little cell with 100 trillion parts in its body. It was all created in His image and in His likeness. And I just close with this appeal. Don't you think it's time that we gave back to God what was already His, namely your body?